When you think about plastic waste, you don't often think about what's inside your closet. The development of the synthetic materials that make our modern clothing more functional, stretchier, and cheaper means that there's actually more plastic waste in our clothes than in the items we expect, like disposable plates or straws.
Textile waste is a very large problem.
Every year, billions of garments go to landfills. And when this happens, your clothes don't just break down and become one with the earth. This is what a single pair of jeans looks like after sitting in a compost bin for a year.
Textiles are these complex mixtures of different materials. Cotton, polyester, spandex, nylon, acrylic.
You can't really do anything with that material. You kind of have to reinvent recycling.
What if instead of reducing textile waste, your next t-shirt could just be made from an old pair of leggings? These two chemists have developed a way to separate these fabrics at the molecular level in order to do just that.
Chemical recycling is kind of the holy grail of fashion.
With the older, extracted material, they're creating a brand new fabric that can be reworn and then recycled again and again.
Can I grab this right here and like show it?
This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems.
Garments get shipped around the world as bales. And so these are your standard 1,200-pound bales.
Right now, when you want to get rid of your clothes, you typically donate them. But eventually, all clothes will become unusable.
We essentially collect garments to learn more about what it is and start testing it in our plant here. If you look in your closet, it's a mixture of stuff. This is some sort of technical outerwear. You can tell there's some polyspan, maybe 91.9 polyspan.
Shay Sethi is a chemist and molecular biologist who, before starting Ambercycle, knew very little about the fashion industry.
My co-founder and I were roommates in college. We really wanted to do something about a big problem, and we thought plastic pollution was a pretty big one.
Shay and his co-founder, Moby Ahmed, first thought that they would work to refine the waste stream of plastic water bottles, and they kept coming back to one ingredient. Polyester.
That seemed like a logical place to start. For the past 4,000 years, our clothing has been mostly one material, and that's cellulose or cotton. If you look at the 12th century, all of our clothing was recycled into paper. And as populations grew, the need for new materials grew as well. As early as 1940, the invention of polyester changed the fashion industry. Asia has really grown from this foundation of polyester, where it's been a very easy to manufacture material from the vast oil resources that have been developed. As early as 2004, polyester has overtaken cotton as the number one material in fashion. This garment, 100% polyester. Look at that.
During their time at college, the two discovered how to chemically separate polyester from fabric and turn it into a new material, creating the Ambercycle process.
What we're essentially doing is purifying and separating polyester from blended textile waste. So clothes come in and we remove the hardware, buttons, zippers, things like that. Take the base textile and we chop it up. It goes through a shredding device. Those shreds then go into a series of basically chemical reactors. It almost looks like an oil refinery. We're turning the polyester into a soup and cleaning it up and building it back up. Really the way to think about it is we're mining for polyester from mixed textile waste. Once we've purified the polyester, we convert that back into yarns and fibers to make new clothing. We call our yarn and fiber Cycora.
Beyond figuring out the technical aspects of Ambercycle, Sethi and Ahmed are particularly focused on making what's known as a circular economy truly viable for the entire fashion industry.
The linear economy is the utilization of materials in one or two life cycles, and then those materials ending up in the waste stream. The circular economy is the idea that the materials we use can be reused almost infinitely, reducing the amount of material that's going to landfill and reducing the need for new materials from the earth.
If we can use these materials more responsibly, they can be regenerated and put back into the cycle again and again and again. But that has to exist in the kind of infrastructure that we're developing.
Getting a garment from someone's closet back into the apparel supply chain is a very, very tricky thing to do, because if there's any bit of friction in that process, you're gonna disincentivize people from wanting to do it. We're trialing things ourselves, and we're also working with a number of different companies, small, medium, and large in the space. The one that we're really interested in is a concept called a digital passport. When you buy a garment made with Cycora, some of them will have a QR code that's on the care label, and this will help inform people about the best options about what to do with their garment once it's at its end of life.
Buying and cycling through clothes is an important way individuals around the world express themselves today. And as more people across the globe gain access to cheaply constructed fashion, this trend is predicted to increase exponentially.
We don't think that's really going to slow down. If anything, it's only going to increase at a faster rate than it is today. And so we have to focus on turning that old material back into new stuff.
Our vision is within the next 3 years to be producing 50,000 tons per year of Cycora. And that's a material that otherwise would have been incinerated. And it's also displacing material that otherwise would have come from oil.
When the fashion industry started, it was all about making garments luxurious or different. But the fundamental basics of clothing are about stories. And so many designers are using sustainability to tell a new and compelling story, because it's one of these things that literally touches every single person. It's clothing. At the end of the day, our process will be so significantly beneficial for the environment, it's going to be hard to imagine why we ever even worked at extracting oil from the earth to make polyester.